gentlemen, indeed joined by and rated after another great performance from SK Gaming, solidly in first place now. Talk me a little bit through the game plan for this one.
Okay, we prepared a lot for this game. We talked through so many scenarios, and the way they banned was actually playing into our favor, because we kind of, we counted on something else, but they didn't do it. Also, I feel like we were on comfort picks for us, and we just played it down slowly but surely. We knew they were lane swapping, so we were preparing in our mind what we had to do, and since we saw they pushed the second turret, we took the second turret as well, so it was just fairly even from the start. Only Freddy died early on, but we also got a catch, so it was even in kills as well, and it just stayed like that for a long time. We tried to rotate, we tried to force, but it was kind of hard against Lulu as well, so it just took us a long time to actually manage to pull ahead, and I think we played all very consistently good, and we didn't do that big of mistakes, therefore we won the match in the end, but they played very well.
That's it.
That's it, pretty much. But I actually would like to know then, how do you guys prepare for these matches? Because every time in Champs, like, I feel like you guys have a plan ready, you always seem to come out ahead in some way. Who's working with you as the team? Do you have a coach or analyst who helps doing, or is it just you guys doing your picks and bans alone?
We have an analyst right now, and he does a great part of the job. I think when it comes to that, there's like a lot of preparation in the beforehand, so everyone is like kind of need to, every new patch has new champions that are OP and just like good matchups that you have to play, and we just go into the room here, talk through everything, picks, bans, and just see what we can do, and that's varied based on the opponents that we actually face.
So you're mentioning the patch, currently we're on 4.3. We saw you starting Spell Thief's Edge on Kayle. Is that your preferred start now if you go for kind of an AP support, or what's kind of the route you go now?
That's very split, that depends. Sometimes you need a tank, sometimes you need just someone to deal a lot of damage. There are a lot of supports that actually deal damage, but all of them have to at least have some utility in some, like, of some sense. Morgana shield, Karma, speed up, etc. There's a lot of stuff that you can pull out right now, and I feel like the support got a lot more versatile than just the three picks at the start of the season.
Yeah, so about these picks, of course, we have seen Karma four times today. I would actually like to know your opinion about Karma as a support.
Very poke heavy, very easy to master. The laning phase is very easy as well, and it's hard to handle as an opponent. I think it pressures a lot, and it's a very good pick right now.
The things you kind of mentioned about Karma are kind of the same things we see in a Morgana support as well. Why do you think that she got picked so heavily 2 weeks ago and now not at all?
It's always because of the meta. The supports that are played, if they are counted by a specific support, that means that support gets hyped. Morgana was good versus any Leona, and even good against Thresh, therefore the laning phase was very solid and the team fights were strong. That's the reason it was picked. Right now, Leona and Annie have fell out of favor, Thresh as well. Like, it's just less played as overall, and so you don't have to counterpick them, and that's why Morgana fell out of favor a bit. I think it's going to be pulled out all the time, just as soon as the support gets picked, which gets countered by Morgana, Morgana is going to be picked again.
It's very true, actually, and a very good point, because we haven't seen Leona that much. But then if we look to someone like Korea, for instance, we see Sivir Leona so often played over there. And in general, talking about Korea, talking about the meta, we just had Intel Extreme Master. Was there anything you saw on the Asian teams that you would like to pick up, or something you're very impressed by?
Well, the Karma overall was a good pick. For example, lane swaps, the way that it played the laning, everything. You can just take something out of every match. But I feel like the Koreans on support, at least, they completely missed out on Morgana as a counter pick, and that's why Leona is more played right there. Mm-hmm. I think Leona versus Morgana is not even a skill matchup. It's just very hard to play out.
We mentioned the Sivir already. Why is it that you went for the Caitlyn in this situation? Because Candy Panda, he got a little behind in the laning phase.
Caitlyn overall is a really strong pick to push, and we know it's a favorable pick of them, so it was a higher priority for us, and we've practiced a lot of Caitlyn because we just feel like changing the champion pool just makes you less predictable, and I feel like Caitlyn was a good pick in that sense, because we wanted to go for objectives overall, and it just worked out.
And I have to ask now, because you guys are number one, we have the all-star trip for the number one team, of course, for you representing Europe here against, of course, Korea, NA, all these very strong teams, how would you actually feel with it, and how do you think you guys would put up a good fight or actually have a chance to win it all?
We would put a lot of preparation into this, and I would be proud to represent Europe. And I feel like right now we are consistently improving still, and we just get more solid and solid, and I don't see a reason why we would not win against Asian teams at this point. We have to put a lot of preparations into it, and depending on that and of course of the enemy teams that we will face, we might have a shot or not, but I feel like we would put up a strong fight.
Right, of course, it's not over yet. So finally, tomorrow you'll be going up against Rocket. After what you've seen here today, how big do you think your chances are?
Right now, we feel confident going into every match, so I predict that we will win. But we have to put a lot of preparations into it, and we don't take any match easily or anyhow, like, easy in a sense. But we put a lot of preparation into this, and we know what we are going to do, and therefore we will win.
Well, it's going to be a great matchup. Well, congratulations here on your win again on the first day here.
Thank you.
And now we're going to head back over to Joe and Quickshot to see where our teams are in the standings.
Thank you very much, Sharks.